Hello you all. Welcome to this new edition of Lectio Musica, the place for great lyrics, great music, and great meaning. As you know, my name is Guylain. I'm a Franciscan friar from Canada. Love rock music for a long time, especially hard rock, metal, and prog. Every week, I come back in the evening in my little office where I work, do some research, and I come and listen to a piece, an instrumental piece that you suggested me. And this series now is on the album Dark Passion Play. I've been working on this album for the past, I think it's 6 weeks, but it's a little bit misleading, this number, because in a previous series I already did three songs of that album. So if you want to appreciate this video, maybe you want to watch the previous songs. They are here in order. So you can see that some of my videos, they have a number like LM70. You just ask for LM70 on the YouTube search engine and you will find immediately my reaction and analysis of the Poet and the Pendulum. And it will be the same thing with Amaranth 71, and 72 will be 7 Days to the Wolves in a previous series called 24 Song to Fall in Love with Nightwish or something like that. I began 6 weeks ago with Bye Bye Beautiful. Then I went to Cadence of Her Last Breath, Master Passion, Greed, Eva, Sahara, Whoever Brings the Night was last week. Don't worry if you haven't seen them. You will appreciate that video, but you will appreciate it even more because I make connections between videos to enhance for myself. It helps me to understand a little bit better, I guess. And I think you appreciate that from me. If you haven't seen these, please proceed and go there. And as I always say, just take the section of the video that interests you. I react to a lyrics video at the beginning. Secondly, I do a short analysis of the lyrics and of the song. And at the end, I give my opinion on the song. Thirdly, I will react to a live version. Now, for this song, there are no live version of Nightwish. I haven't found any. But I found something quite rare. It's a live acapella recording of Anette, recording herself apparently in her own home or something with a phone. Nothing fancy, but I think we can appreciate the video anyways. As for now, we will go then to the first section called the reaction to a lyrics video. And for that, I have chosen for you one video that I found that was quite the main, for me, the main criterion is the fact that the words are very clear. And this one has, if I remember well, beautiful images to accompany the song. So, without adding anything, let's go and listen to the lyrics, a lyrics video of the song called For the Heart I Once Had. 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.
really looking forward to go to progress in our exploration of the lyrics and the melody. Out of the starting blocks, I get from that song the impression that Nightwish and the composer, Thomas, are in, I will say, another musical landscape. They left the very neoclassical style that they were able to bring with Tarja, and now they are embracing a pop metal style that we have seen in two songs, at least Amaranth, and maybe also even Bye-Bye Beautiful in a way. There is something of that quality, a very refined pop melody that is arranged while including metal instruments. But per se, well, I don't think we can talk about metal music, even symphonic metal, even if there are arrangements of strings and choir in the background. Certainly this song could give all its richness without them. In this case, the solo, the guitar solo, I would say the introduction would be more accurate. The melody is based on the verse and not the chorus. That's usually, you keep the very beautiful melodic line for the chorus. In this case, I'm not afraid to say that even if the chorus melody is beautiful, the verses is exquisite. And that's why I think that Empu chose the melodic lines of the verses to do the introduction. It's a gorgeous line. So let's dig into the lyrics. First verse. Heaven today is but a way to a place I once called home. Heart of a child, one final sight, as another love goes cold. Once my heart beat to the rhythm of the falling snow, blackened below, the river now flows, a stream of molten virgin snow. So, heaven today is not a future, is not something towards which I walk, but this is more something I once experienced. And we have seen that theme many times in many songs. There is something that was experienced in the childhood of Nightwish that is where the band is really attached to. The composer, Thomas, is very attached to the childhood. There is something absolutely wonderful that he regrets that is not part of his actual life, and he talks about it not as something in the future, but something in the past. This heaven was his home. This is what he calls home. And for him, in that home, in that life, was a heavenly quality. For him, there's no reason to expect or wish for something else. Now, in this heaven, there was a heart of a child. We've seen that so very often. The child, the heart, the innocence that one time, a long time ago, he has been lost by something, by a series of events. And now another love goes cold by that, it's probably that there is one love that was part of the child. It's not the only one, but a series of losses broke the child's heart. And now it's full of scars, it's full of broken pieces, and the man regrets the time where this was his life or his home, his history. Now, once my heart beat to the rhythm of the falling snow, so the heart was at peace with the falling snow. Of course, we're not talking about a snowstorm here. I am certain that we're talking about these beautiful romantic snowfall that we see in every movies where people fall in love in winter. It goes down very slowly. So once my heart was peaceful as this, black and below the river now flows a stream of molten virgin snow. So the events made the snow melt. The series of events melt the snow. So in a sense, whiteness is getting lost in the process, transforming into water. And now it flows under the surface because if on the surface it's white, under there's something black. But at the same time, I might add, it's life. Water is life. So yeah, there's a loss, but there's also probably growth involved and evolution. But it doesn't prevent us to live or to feel that we lost something. Anyways, that's how I understand that first verse. Does that make sense to you? Write it below if you think I'm completely in the, we say in French, in the left field, dans le champ gauche, from baseball, completely out of the center. Now, here is the chorus. For the heart I'll never have, for the child forever gone. The music flows because it longs for the heart I once had. For the heart I had and I will never have. There is something lost in the process. And the child now is forever gone. Though, like the water was flowing now, the source is the loss. The source of the music is the loss. And we've seen that theme very often in the past albums and songs of Nightwish. Because even if the scars, the events, those who breaks the heart of the composers, they are painful, they are difficult to experience, they are still the source of his creativity. His creativity is born of the suffering, in fact, of these series of events. It is right, exactly, directly connected with all the past songs I can see. Past album, very easy to connect this song with the rest of Nightwish's repertoire. The music flows because it longs for the heart I once had. So the longing for the child's heart is the well of the poetry and of the music. Verse 2. Living today without a way to understand the weight of the world. Faded and torn, old and forlorn, my weak and hoping heart. For the child, for the light, for the heart that once had, I will believe and foresee everything I could ever be. This is an interesting paragraph. Very interesting. As you can see, basically, every verse is made of two times the same structure. So it's a two-section verse, two sections. But it's in terms of music, it's a repetition of the same cycle two times. Today I live without a way. Well, remember in the first verse we saw, heaven is not in the future, but in the place I used to call home. So if that fades away, if that memory is broken by a series of events, you can understand that today he lives without a way, without a direction, without heaven as being an orientation, even though the song implies that this heaven was in the past, longing for something that I once experienced, and now that I try to find, but I will not find anymore. Now, without a way to understand the weight of the world, this for me is a little bit intriguing because if I understand this line, I would put it in front of the album Human Nature. Remember how the music, the themes of Nightwish, all the way up to Imaginarium, are personal experiences, but with the album Most Beautiful Works of Nature, Most Beautiful, or I'm sorry, I don't remember the exact title of the album, but with many beautiful songs, and Human Nature, you see the composer opening his heart and his mind to the whole world, as if the personal issues that were the matter of previous albums prevented him to open his eyes, to understand the world, the weight of the world. That's how I would understand. What do you think of that? That's how I would put this line in connection with Human Nature and the previous Endless Form, more beautiful, most beautiful. Faded and torn, the heart, my weak and hoping heart, faded and torn, old and forlorn. So the heart now is not childlike, it's tired. It's the heart of a tired man. It doesn't have a way. I would say a lens, or even we could say telescope, that would bring it to focus his understanding of the world. So there's a lack of direction that is implied here, because the heart feels tired, but still it's weak, but it's hoping, and in this hope you can make a connection with the second part of this verse. For the child, for the light, for the heart I once had, I will believe and foresee everything I could ever be. This is very interesting because the little light that is still there of this child, for this child, I will believe and foresee the one I can be. So I'll pass through that fading thorn, old and forlorn heart, I will pass through those events that caused this situation. And the child heart that I will never have, but for that heart I once had, I will believe and foresee the one I can become. And no doubt that the man will assume his present state while including the heart of the child that he was. But he will not be only the child. He will be something more, where the child will have some space, even if at times he feels like the child had to die. I will not go through the chorus another time, simply a few words about the bridge, which is quite simple, quite short, I should say. Time will not heal a dead boy's scars. Time will kill. That's the opening of the whole album, The Poet and the Pendulum. And we can refer to the previous song from a previous album, Dead Boy's Poem. We know now what is the dead boy's. The dead boy is the man who lost his innocence because of the events of his life. It's not a physical death, it's a psychological, spiritual, moral death. Something died of himself in this process. And but as is written here, the scars are so deep that he thinks at this point that he will not heal, he can only die. I don't think it's accurate. And I don't think the author thinks that as well. The writing of songs is a way to heal. But with The Poet and the Pendulum, clearly the duration, the time, the excruciating situation that lasted a long time finally got to him and make him lose all innocence. That's how I can understand this. It makes so much sense with everything else that we've read. And we will not take more time for the chorus that you already know. So let's go directly to the analysis of this song. The structure is very basic, very simple. A, B, A, B, that means one verse, one chorus, one verse, one chorus, and then C means the bridge. So in looking at these six letters, you understand immediately the structure of the song. The long hyphen you have at the beginning means there's a long instrumental section at the beginning, and we have, I don't remember if it's a little bit before the bridge, there's a small section here, and maybe there's one right after, but there's a beautiful modulation, which means that the intensity raises with the last chorus. Now, the melodic value of this song is very high, especially of the verses. So the introduction, the guitar solo at the beginning, is based on the verse, the melody of the verses, and it's a very good choice. The bridge is very interesting as well. So the whole song is beautiful, but it's not of a metal quality. I would call it a more rich pop melody. Even if the arrangements are metal at some, I'd say for the second chorus and after, still it will be more accurate to call it a pop rock song with metal instruments than a real, I would say, metal song. As for the lyrics, there's a clear connection with the opening, The Poet and the Pendulum, and even of Dead Boy's Poem that we already... basically, it's written, so there's no way to avoid this. That's part of the song. And the theme, it's not them, it's the theme that we see again of the child being the innocent and pure part of oneself. This part that is called Amaranth in the song of the same name. Now, in terms of analysis, now let's look at the broader analysis of the connection of this song with the previous song, except the last one. The last one seems to be out of theme, but still, we can find connection with all of these. But all the songs before the last one, there's a common theme, very clear. It's obvious. It developed quite, I will say it a little, systematically, the same theme. Now, there are many ways to tell a story. There's a, I would say, an external way to move the story from point A to a point B, to be the observer of a story. That's pretty much the way we see movies unfold. We are like an external observer being witness. Or witnessing all the events that we see unfolding in front of our eyes. In this case, this album is made in another way. It seems to me that's pretty much the same event or very closely related events, but that are developed from different points of view. You have the same event, but then I see it from this point of view, and then from this one, and this one, and this one. So variations of the same story, or very closely related events. And for me, I think it's very beautiful. For me, this album tells me something that will happen to a level that I absolutely loved. With human nature, is that it's not a linear story in any way, but it's point of views of a problem or a thing or a situation. We just look at it from different point of view, different perspectives. That's at a more personal level or a smaller level. We see that here operating very well. It's beautiful. Clear connection between Eva and the child's heart I once had. It's two characters, but two characters that used to be connected in a way, Eva and this poet and or this person here. So the wounded man is afraid of having lost something of himself forever, but personally I think it's not the case, but at the time he might have thought that it was the case. Now, my opinion is that the story unfolds slowly with changes of perspective, and those changes are very beautiful to read and to experience as listeners of those songs. It's very beautiful. Now, there's a very high quality value in the melody of this song. It's unmistakably good. There is no one in the world, no musician in the world, will listen to Amaranth or this song and say, well, that's not a good melody. No, no, no. There's no doubt that the melody is gold in this song. That being said, we are not in metal and symphonic metal anymore. There was always in Nightwish a romantic heart behind the project of Nightwish. So it's, even if it's metal, it's romantic. It's, and I think we better understand Nightwish if we situate Nightwish in the romantic period of classical music with a metal ensemble, then if we put Nightwish in the metal scene, it makes more sense to me. And in fact, this is why I consider it closer to movie scores and music and John Williams and so many others. It's more of that quality. In fact, most of I would say that most of film music is romantic at its base. And in this album, this element expresses itself even more. It was there already in the past, very strong, but here we have it explodes in a way, in many aspects, both in anger, in fury, in kindness as well. And so this is pretty much what I see from that song and how it fits in the album. Now, I understand the fans of the previous albums that I loved, by the way. We are in another musical culture here. This song fits Anette's voice so well that I wonder if it was not composed specifically for her voice. I know how before Thomas wrote songs for Tardia, really to give her the stage with the color of her voice, the quality of her voice, her persona. I would say that this song seems to me fitting so well Anette's voice that I get the impression that it was specifically written for her. I don't have the answer to that, but that's the impression I get. Now, because the singer changed, and the singer is the instrument of, in the case of Nightwish, of a vision, of artistic vision, because the instrument changed, the composer explored other musical landscapes. And for me, this is the perfect example for that. This new voice gave him the possibility to explore something new. And this is what he did with that song. Next week, it will be the song The Islander. Now, I don't remember by memory this song, but I remember one thing. It has been suggested by the fans, even in the first series I did on Nightwish. This is one song that the fans love very much. I will probably recognize it when I will hear it, but as for now, it doesn't sound familiar to me. Don't forget, every reaction, every premiere on Fridays at 1:30 in Montreal time. It's usually something like 7:30 in Western Europe. Always includes reactions to the lyrics, to an analysis to the of the lyrics and of the song, and finally reaction to a live video. Most of the time, when we find one, and in this case, in this album, it's the first time I have so much problem finding some of these songs in a live version. Don't forget that the whole, you can connect right here, down here, the closed caption, which are the subtitles. And after you chose, right beside it, you will see a small wheel. In this wheel, you can choose the language of your choice. You have 8 languages. The subtitles are in 8 languages. I work very hard on the English and the French, and the language I understand, I verify if the translation is well done. I cannot make professional level of subtitles all by myself, but I think that according to what you told me, they are very good. The quality is quite good. Much better anyways than those who are automatically produced by YouTube. So there we are. We are finished. And let's listen now to a video that is quite unusual. I don't know if it's a good video. I just listened to a few bars of the melody and I say, oh, that's interesting. I haven't found a show of this song. I have no clue if it's worth the listening. But since it's the only one we have, I say, why not? Let's try it. I think that we never lose in trying new things. Until now, I've been thrilled by new things that I've found on my journey through the Nightwish repertoire. So let's go and listen. What is an acapella with a small phone, apparently, Anette filming herself singing a song she once recorded? 3, 2, 1.
Heaven today is but a way to a place I once called home. Heart of a child won't find a sign as another love goes cold. Once my heart beat to the rhythm of the falling snow, black and below the river that flows, a stream of molten virgin snow. For the heart I never had, child forever gone, the music flows because it longs for the heart I once had. Living today without a way to understand the weight of the world, faded and torn, old and forlorn, my weak and hoping heart. For the child, for the night, for the heart I once had, I believe and foresee everything I could ever be. For the heart I never had, child forever gone, the music flows because it longs for the heart I once had. Time will not heal a dead boy's scars. Time will keep for the heart I never had, for the child forever gone, the music flows because it loves.
Well, that's a nice surprise. I enjoyed it. So, yeah, she can push, eh? She can push. There's some power in there. And we can see the little variations that are quite interesting. Still, in an a cappella situation, we see every single little fault. So it takes some courage to do that and to offer it to the public, but we can see that she was able to go through it quite well. So that's it for this week. Next week, the islander. We'll go through that next week. For now, bye-bye.